I think everything is fine now. We can start. Good evening, everyone. This is Dr. Sandeep Madan, and I am an ADME faculty at DEMS. And today we are going to look at the demo lecture. And the topic of today is mandibular nerve along with the parasympathetic ganglia. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the ophthalmic and the maxillary division of the trigeminal nerve. And I have discussed about the topographical nerve of the parasympathetic ganglia. Topographical nerve is that nerve which holds the ganglia, and the functional nerve is that nerve which actually brings the preganglionic fibers to the ganglia, right? So let us now continue and look at the mandibular nerve. Okay, in the previous class we have seen that we have this one is our trigeminal ganglia, and the trigeminal ganglia basically divides into ophthalmic, maxillary and the mandibular division. This is the mandibular division which is actually exiting through the foramen ovale, and we know mandibular nerve is not the only structure which passes through the foramen ovale. Overall, male structure exit from the foramen ovale. What is male is a mnemonic. M is for mandibular nerve, A is for accessory meningeal artery, L is for lesser petrosal nerve, and E is for M3 vein, right? Now let us begin and understand about the mandibular nerve. See, the mandibular nerve is the only mixed part of the trigeminal, because the trigeminal, two components of the trigeminal, that is ophthalmic division and the maxillary division, are pure sensory branches, whereas the mandibular nerve is a mixed nerve. It receives sensory fibers as well as the mixed fibers, right? So let me draw and explain. Let me draw the schematic diagram and explain. Right. So basically, if you, that is our topic today, mandibular nerve. And mandibular nerve exits from this foramen, which is foramen ovale. And behind we have this foramen, that is foramen spinosum. Okay, this is foramen ovale. This one is foramen spinosum. And we know the sensory root is coming along with the motor root. So this is motor root. This one is the sensory root. Both of them, they become the, you see, mixed nerve. Both of them, they will become a mixed trunk of the mandibular nerve. This is the mixed trunk of the mandibular nerve. Okay, so this is the trunk of the mandibular nerve. Now, what are the branches from the mandibular nerve? Before that, let us understand that the trunk of the mandibular nerve, which is mixed in nature, it holds the ganglia, that is otic ganglia. That means we can say the trunk of the mandibular nerve, the trunk of the mandibular nerve is topographical for the otic ganglia, isn't it? Right. Now, what are the nerves? What are the branches from the trunk? Branches from the trunk, you see, first branch that it gives is the meningeal branch. Okay. And remember, the mandibular nerve, as soon as it gets out of the foramen ovale, it remembers that, oh, I forgot to supply the meninges when I was well within the cranial cavity. What should I do now? I should send one nerve back. The nerve going back is the recurrent meningeal nerve. And because it passes through the foramen spinosum, it is called as nervus spinosum. So what is this? This is nervus spinosum, which is nothing but the recurrent meningeal branch of mandibular nerve. Is that fine? Yes. And one of the branch here is nerve to medial pterygoid. One of the branches is nerve to medial pterygoid. This nerve to medial pterygoid actually passes through the otic ganglion. It simply passes through the ganglion. Nothing, it is not related to the ganglion functionally. Fine. So this nerve is called as nerve to medial pterygoid. Obviously, it is going to supply the medial pterygoid muscle, but along with that, it is going to take care of two more muscles. And what are these two muscles? These are tensor tympani एंड टेंसर वैली पैलिटिनी. ओके, टेंसर टिम्पेनाई एंड टेंसर वैली पैलिटिनी. सो दीज आर टू नर्व्स, टू ब्रांचेस विच आर फ्रॉम द गिवन ऑफ फ्रॉम द ट्रंक, राइट. आफ्टर दैट वी कैन सी दैट द ट्रंक डिवाइड्स इंटू टू डिविजन्स, एंटीरियर डिविजन एंड द पोस्टीरियर डिविजन. एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर डिविजन, दिस इज एंटीरियर डिविजन, दिस इज पोस्टीरियर डिविजन. द एंटीरियर डिविजन इज मेनली मोटर, ओके, एंड इट इज गोइंग टू टेक केयर ऑफ द मसल्स ऑफ मैस्टिकेशन, राइट. एज वी नो द मसल्स ऑफ मैस्टिकेशन आर द डेराइवेटिव ऑफ द फर्स्ट फेरेंजियल आर्च, एंड द मैंडिबुलर नर्व इज ऑल्सो द नर्व ऑफ फर्स्ट फेरेंजियल आर्च. इट इज गोइंग टू टेक केयर ऑफ ऑल द मसल्स विच आर द डेराइवेटिव ऑफ फर्स्ट फेरेंजियल आर्च, इजंट इट. So, anterior division is going to supply the remaining muscles of mastication. Now, if I ask you, what are the muscles of mastication? You will say medial pterygoid, lateral pterygoid, temporalis, and the masseter. Fine. Now, if I ask you, if buccinator is muscle of mastication, the answer is no, because it does not do the mastication process as such, but it does help in mastication by bringing the food in the mainstream, so that it can be chewed. So it is an accessory muscle for mastication. Per se, buccinator belongs to muscle of facial expression, not muscle of mastication. So buccinator will not be supplied by the mandibular nerve, fine. But the four muscles of mastication will be supplied, yes. Out of these four, one has already been supplied from the branch which was given by the trunk. So now we are left with three muscles. These three muscles will be taken care of by the branch from the anterior division, right? So now you see, we have these branches. One of them is going to supply the lateral pterygoid muscle. Okay. And the other is going to take care of temporalis muscle, the deep temporal nerve. And one is going to supply the masseter muscle. And the last branch, you can say only one sensory branch is there, and what is that? That is buccal nerve. Buccal nerve is the only sensory branch. Buccal nerve is the only sensory branch, and it supplies in the mucous membrane and the cheek, the skin and the mucous membrane of the cheek region. Okay, and it pierces buccinator but does not supply it. It pierces buccinator but does not supply it. Yes. All right. Now, what about the posterior division branches? The posterior division branches are, that can be remembered by the mnemonic Ali. That can be remembered by the mnemonic Ali. Okay. What is the meaning of Ali? Like A, L, and I. A is for auriculotemporal nerve. A is for auriculotemporal nerve. Auriculotemporal nerve. This auriculotemporal nerve. Auriculotemporal nerve is going to supply one gland, that is parotid gland. After it is done with the parotid gland, it also supplies part of pinna and then goes over to the temple, that is the scalp region. Fine. So this is the distribution of the auriculotemporal nerve. Okay, then we have lingual nerve, L for lingual and I for inferior alveolar. Let me explain this part here. See, we have mandible. If you take a section here, we have taken the hemisection of the mandible, okay. This is the mandibular foramen. This is the mandibular foramen. Fine. Below we have the hyoid bone here. below we have the hyoid bone here, and we have one muscle which is attached from mandibular to hyoid is mylohyoid, making the floor of mouth. And here we have another muscle, anterior belly of digastric. Okay, anterior belly of digastric. This is anterior belly of digastric. This one is mylohyoid between the mandible and hyoid bone. Fine. And here we have teeth. This is third molar teeth. Fine. Now from this posterior division we have one branch which is inferior alveolar. It will simply enter into the mandibular foramen, okay, and then it will travel along the inside, I mean the canal within the mandible. It is going to take care of all the teeth in the lower jaw. Okay, that is why it is called as inferior alveolar nerve or the dental nerve, inferior dental nerve. Fine. Yes. And it is going to divide here into the mental branch, which comes out, the mental nerve comes out and supplies the skin here, the chin and the lower lip region. Okay. And here before entering into the mandibular foramen, it gives one branch. This branch supplies mylohyoid and anterior belly of digastric. Okay, what is the name of this branch? This is called as nerve to mylohyoid. And what was L? L was this nerve which actually goes to the tongue, okay, which actually goes to the tongue in the anterior two-third part. Okay, the important thing is it comes in very close relation to third molar teeth, the root of third molar teeth. Why this is important? Because it has got the surgical importance. If there is any, you see, manipulation or removal of the third molar, then the chances are there the lingual nerve may be involved, right? And if it is involved because of proximity, then the general sensation in the anterior two-third of the tongue will be lost, isn't it? Okay, so these are the branches from the posterior division. These are the branches from the posterior division. Fine. Now, if I draw one artery which passes between the two roots of auriculotemporal and finally it passes through this foramen spinosum, can you name the artery? What is the name of this artery which passes between the two roots of auriculotemporal and finally passes through the foramen spinosum and it reaches deep to pterion where it divides? Okay. So this is nothing but middle meningeal artery. This is nothing but middle meningeal artery. Middle meningeal artery. Right? So these are the different parts of mandibular nerve. I hope it is clear. Now let us revise this much. Okay. Let us revise this much, all the branches, and then I will tell you how to remember these branches. Okay. Let us revise. Yes, students, have you understood? This much is clear. Let us revise quickly. So we have sensory and the motor roots of the mandibular nerve. The trunk of the mandibular nerve passes through the foramen ovale. It holds one ganglion called as otic ganglion. From the trunk itself, two branches are given off. One is this branch, which will actually go back and supply the meninges within the cranial cavity. This is called as nervous spinosum because it passes through the foramen spinosum. And what is this branch actually? Recurrent meningeal branch of the mandibular nerve. Yes. Now the another nerve is this branch, which actually passes through the optic ganglion, and it is called as nerve to medial pterygoid, nerve to medial pterygoid. And this branch will also take care of tensor tympani muscle and the tensor valley palatini muscle. Fine. And you see, after that, the trunk divides into anterior and posterior division. As I told, anterior division will take care of remaining muscles of mastication. So it will supply the lateral pterygoid. It will supply the temporalis by the deep temporal branch. And by the masseteric branch, it will go and supply the masseter. It will give one sensory branch, that is buccal branch, which is sensory. The important point about buccal branch is it will pierce buccinator, but does not supply it. It pierces buccinator, but does not supply it. Okay. Now, after that, in the posterior division, we have seen it gives three branches. I mean, the mnemonic is ALI. A is auriculotemporal nerve. Auriculotemporal is going to supply the parotid and then the auricle, that is pinna, and then it goes to the temple. What is L is the lingual nerve. I told the important clinical importance point here. It lies very close in the close proximity to root or third molar teeth, right? And the inferior alveolar nerve, it enters into the mandibular foramen here. Then it travels within the canal and it takes care of all the teeth like molar, premolar. Okay. And then it divides into mental branch, which comes out through the mental foramen. So as to supply the chin and the lower lip, it gives the other branch, which is incisive branch, which will take care of the incisors and the canine. So basically inferior alveolar takes care of all the teeth, also the cutaneous distribution here. Yes. Before entering into this mandibular foramen, it also supplies the mylohyoid and anterior belly of digastric. Is that fine? Yes. Now, how to remember all these branches? Let me tell you that the muscles which are taking origin or which are deriving or the developing from the first arch, those muscles will be supplied by the mandibular nerve, because the mandibular nerve is the nerve of first arch, right? So what are the muscles which are the derivative of the first arch? So first arch basically gives these muscles. We can remember them by using this mnemonic. The mnemonic is my must aunt, my must aunt digest tension. My must aunt digest tension is the mnemonic. And what is the meaning? My is mylohyoid. Must is the mastication group. Aunt digest is anterior belly of digastric. And tensors are two tensors, that is tensor tympani and tensor valley palatini. Fine. So these are the muscles overall which are supplied by the mandibular nerve. Okay. All right. Let me quickly show you. Then I'll show the diagram. Here, very first branch supplies one muscle of mastication and also two tensor muscles. All right. Anterior division supplies these three muscles of mastication which are remaining. Fine. And now we are left with only two muscles, mylohyoid and the anterior belly of digastric, which will be supplied here, right, by this branch. So these are the muscular branches. Fine. Now let me show you the diagram, the different branches of mandibular nerve. Okay. See, here we can see this muscle, this part here we can see. This is the part, the trunk. Okay. This is the part which is called as the trunk. And here we can see the anterior division and the posterior division, right? This part is the posterior division. This part is the anterior division. Anterior division is mainly supplying the muscles. If you follow, this branch goes through the temporalis muscle. Okay. And this one is the buccal branch. This one is the buccal branch. Okay. Which is going to supply the, you see the mucosa of the cheek, but not the buccinator muscle as such. Fine. In the posterior branch, let me show you the posterior divisions. This, if you can follow this, the two roots of auriculotemporal, it is going to supply the parotid here, then the it is finally going to the temple region. Okay, that is the scalp part. And this nerve is, this is inferior alveolar nerve. This is inferior alveolar nerve. Inferior alveolar nerve is actually going to enter within the mandible. Okay, so mandible would have been here like this. Mandible would have been here, but the mandible has been removed. We appreciate mandible has been removed like this. Otherwise, mandible would have been present here. All right. So this part has been removed so as to see the course of the nerve. And the nerve is also cut. But before entering here, this nerve is given off. This small branch is actually going to supply where we can see two muscles. This is the hyoid bone here. This is the hyoid bone. This is the mandible. We can see this floor of mouth here. This is the floor of mouth, mylohyoid muscle. This is anterior belly of digastric. So this branch which is coming, this branch which is coming, like this is the nerve to mylohyoid coming from the inferior inferior alveolar. It is going to supply two muscles. We can follow. We can see this is going to supply two muscles, this one above and the below. That is the mylohyoid and the anterior belly of digastric. So these are the branches, right? And one of the branch here is the lingual nerve. Now lingual nerve holds one ganglion. What is the name of the ganglion? That is submandibular ganglion. Submandibular ganglion. Okay. So the lingual nerve holds submandibular ganglion. Now in this diagram of the mandibular nerve, we have seen two ganglia. One of them was otic ganglion, which was held by the trunk of the mandibular nerve. The other is a submandibular ganglion, which is held again by the lingual nerve. Fine. Now, as I told in the previous class that we will be making one important table about the ganglia. Okay. And in this table, we will write all the important points. Okay. Which will help you for very quick revision. Okay. When you are revising this topic of parasympathetic ganglia, it will become very easy for you to revise using that table. Fine. Let me explain all the parts about the ganglia. Then I will give you the table. Fine. Here in the previous, let me just revise. In the previous discussion, we have talked about the ciliary ganglion. What was the ciliary ganglion? It was held by the nasociliary nerve. Okay. This was the nasociliary nerve. Fine. And this is pterygopalatine ganglion, which is present in the pterygopalatine fossa. Pterygoid plate on one side, palate on the other side, and we have a fossa. This is pterygopalatine fossa. Inside the pterygopalatine fossa, we have a ganglion, pterygopalatine ganglion, which was held by this nerve, that is maxillary nerve. Okay. So basically, topographical branches for the all parasympathetic ganglia are the branches from fifth nerve. Okay. But functional nerves are different. Functional nerves are 3rd, 7th, 9th and 10th. Fine. So let us now make a table. Okay. Let us now make a table and then we will proceed. Fine. All right. See, if we understand, this is the ganglia name that we are going to write. Okay. Here we are going to write the functional nerve. Functional nerve means the nerve which is bringing the preganglionic fiber. Here we are going to write the topographical nerve. Topographical nerve means which is holding the ganglion. This is the target tissue. It can be muscle or gland. Target tissue. And this is what is the nucleus, from where the fibers begin. From where the fibers begin. Fine. Now, what are the names of the ganglia? We know we have ciliary ganglion. Okay. Then we have pterygopalatine ganglion. Then we have submandibular ganglion. And then we have otic ganglion. Okay. What are the nerves which are, now let us discuss one by one. For the ciliary ganglion, the fibers, parasympathetic fibers, which are relaying in the ciliary ganglion, they take origin in which nucleus? Answer, Edinger Westphal nucleus. So we have Edinger Westphal nucleus here. And which nerve brings the fiber, which carries the fiber? That is nerve to inferior oblique, nerve to inferior oblique, that belongs to third nerve, that belongs to third nerve. And what is the topographical nerve for the ciliary ganglion? Is the nasociliary nerve, nasociliary nerve. And what is the target tissue? What is the target tissue? That is sphincter pupillae muscle. Sphincter pupillae muscle and the ciliaries. Okay. Right. Now for the pterygopalatine ganglion, pterygopalatine ganglion is which nucleus sends the fiber for the pterygopalatine ganglion, where the fibers are actually going for. The pterygopalatine ganglion is mainly postganglionic fibers are mainly given to the lacrimal gland. Also, it gives to some small glands in like nasal, palatine and the pharyngeal, but mainly it gives in the lacrimal. So the fibers begin from the lacrimal nucleus. Okay, fibers begin in the lacrimal nucleus. And the functional nerve for the pterygopalatine ganglion is the greater petrosal nerve. Greater petrosal nerve. Okay, which actually becomes the nerve of pterygoid canal along with the deep petrosal nerve that we have discussed in the previous class, if you remember that. And what is the topographical nerve? Maxillary nerve. Okay. And what is the target tissue? Target tissue here is mainly the lacrimal gland, mainly the lacrimal gland. Along with that, we have nasal, palatine and pharyngeal. Fine. The next we are going to talk about submandibular ganglion. Submandibular ganglion is going to take care of the submandibular gland and the sublingual gland. Submandibular and the sublingual glands are salivary glands. Okay, we have three major salivary glands: parotid, submandibular and sublingual. And out of these three, two are taken care of by the submandibular ganglion. Fine. And because these are the salivary glands, the fibers must come from the salivary nucleus. From which nucleus the fibers will come? From superior salivary nucleus. From superior salivary nucleus. And what, which nerve carries it? It is the cauda tympani. It is the cauda tympani. Okay. Cauda tympani is a part of seventh nerve. Even the greater petrosal was part of seventh nerve. Okay. And submandibular ganglion is held by which nerve? Submandibular ganglion is held by lingual nerve. Lingual nerve. And what is the target tissue? Target tissue is submandibular and sublingual gland. Submandibular and sublingual gland. Fine. Next is for the otic ganglion, we have inferior salivary nucleus. And which nerve carries it? The fibers are carried by lesser petrosal nerve. Okay. And what is the topographical nerve? Topographical nerve for the otic is the mandibular nerve. Okay. And what is the target tissue? Is parotid gland. Fine. Now only one thing. If I ask you which gland is superior in position, so parotid is superior, but its nucleus is inferior. Okay. Whereas submandibular and sublingual are inferior in position, right? But its nucleus is superior salivary nucleus. Fine. And the lesser petrosal is indirectly a branch of ninth nerve. Okay. I hope it is clear to you guys. Yes, is it clear? Once you are done with this information, then we can take one question, right? Let me show you the question then. See, this is a quick summary. With the third nerve, okay, the fibers are brought to the ciliary ganglion, which will reach the sphincter pupillae and the ciliaris muscle. Okay, the seventh nerve brings the fiber for the lacrimal gland, which relay in the sphenopalatine or the pterygopalatine ganglion. Okay, seventh nerve also gives the fibers to submandibular ganglion for the submandibular and the sublingual gland. And the ninth nerve brings the fiber for the otic ganglion, which finally relays in the parotid gland. The tenth nerve, it goes to the remaining part of the parasympathetic, okay, right? Again, this is the diagram showing that for each ganglia, we do not have only the parasympathetic, we also have the sympathetic fibers which reach by wrapping themselves around some artery. For example, we discuss about the deep petrosal nerve, and what was this petrosal nerve? Nothing but the sympathetic fiber around the internal carotid artery. Similarly, for the ciliary ganglion, we have some fibers around the internal carotid artery which will simply pass through the ganglion. Okay, that is a sympathetic fiber, fine. And for this pathways we have discussed in the previous class, if you remember, the zygomaticotemporal, and finally it was giving the communicating and then to the lacrimal. Yes, so that part we have discussed in the previous class about the lacrimal pathway. I hope you remember that, fine. And in this class we have seen about two ganglia. One of them is the otic ganglion. Otic ganglion is held by the mandibular nerve, and the other is actually this is the lingual nerve here. Okay, and the lingual nerve is approached by the coda tympani. This nerve is the coda tympani, okay, which will bring the preganglionic parasympathetic fibers for the lingual nerve. Let us take this question. This question is match column A with column B. Okay, here we have been given the parasympathetic ganglia, and we have to match them with preganglionic parasympathetic fibers. Preganglionic parasympathetic fibers are nothing but the functional nerves. Okay, now what is the answer for the first choice, that is pterygopalatine ganglion? Which nerve brings the fibers here? You have to answer now. Yes, students, please respond. What should be the answer? A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Out of these choices, what are you going to write against pterygopalatine ganglion? We know the pterygopalatine ganglion is for the lacrimation, and which nerve brings the fiber here? Greater petrosal nerve, right? Greater petrosal nerve. B, very good, very good. For the otic ganglion, what do you think? For the otic ganglion, we have which nerve? For the otic ganglion, we have lesser petrosal nerve, right? And submandibular ganglion, for submandibular ganglion, what should be the nerve for submandibular ganglion? Which nerve brings the fiber? Lingual holds it, but the fibers are brought by the coda tympani. So answer E. And what about the ciliary ganglion? Ciliary ganglion, as we know, the functional fibers are brought by the nerve to inferior oblique. Okay, nerve to inferior oblique. Okay. Submandibular ganglion, the holding nerve is the lingual nerve, whereas the fibers are brought by the coda tympani, and ciliary ganglion is actually held by the nasociliary nerve, okay, and the nerve to inferior oblique, right? All right, in the previous class we have seen one diagram. There I have shown you two petrosal nerves. Okay, let me take you back to that diagram. Let me give you one more picture there. Yeah, this one. In the previous class we discussed about this nerve. This is the section here. This is internal acoustic meatus. This is the petrous part of temporal bone. What if this nerve is greater petrosal nerve? What if this nerve here, blue nerve, is deep petrosal nerve? This is deep petrosal nerve. and then it becomes the nerve of pterygoid canal here, that is the median nerve. Yes, and here we can see two holes are there, one and the second. What are these foramen for? Or the hiatus? One, the bigger one is for the greater petrosal nerve. The other one, the smaller one, is for the lesser petrosal nerve. Okay, because you see this greater petrosal nerve and the lesser petrosal nerve, they are coming from within the petrous bone. Okay, but they want to first pierce the petrous bone and they become superficial to it. If you remember in the previous class, I told you both greater and the lesser petrosal nerve are superficial petrosal nerve, right? That is why their complete name is greater superficial petrosal nerve and the lesser superficial petrosal nerve. Deep petrosal nerve is called as deep petrosal because it is deep to the petrous bone. Fine. Now we can see here one nerve is already shown. The other nerve will come out from this part. What should be the name of this nerve? This is lesser petrosal nerve. Okay. Now it wants to exit. It will exit through which foramen? Foramen ovale. Do you appreciate? It will exit through foramen ovale. Okay, so this is about the greater petrosal, deep petrosal and the lesser petrosal nerve. Is that fine? Yes, that means we can say, that means we can say when we have this is foramen ovale, from the foramen ovale, from the foramen ovale, we have this nerve which is mandibular nerve. Mandibular nerve, it exits from the foramen ovale. It will hold one ganglion. It will hold one ganglion. That is otic ganglion. And the nerve along, which is actually exiting from the foramen ovale along with the mandibular nerve, is the lesser petrosal. It will reach here and relay. So lesser petrosal nerve will go out of the foramen ovale and it will relay in the otic ganglion. Okay, and after that there will be relay here and the postganglionic fibers are delivered by the auriculotemporal nerve. Is that okay? So this is about the relay which is taking place in the otic ganglion, and I hope it is clear to you. Is it clear? Yes. So we have seen now the course and the branches of the mandibular nerve. I have given you the mnemonic, how to remember the branches. Okay. And also I have shown you the petrosal nerves and why they are called as superficial and the deep petrosal nerve. And also we have seen, we have made one table of the ganglia, and I do believe this table is going to help you for quick revision. Okay. And fine. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. This is my number 9896542122. Okay. And keep watching such demo sessions. Okay. All the very best. If you have any doubt, I can take now. You want me to take more? Yeah, in the next class, Surbhi, I will plan for those images. Okay, I hope this session was helpful. Because of this, we have that limited time for the demo. So that is why we take small topics. Anna, that is the only reason. Otherwise, attend my class. I will teach the whole anatomy. All right. And you see. Okay, I will take more class and I will include the these images that you have asked. All right. Cadaveric images. Okay. All the very best. In case you have any doubt, not only from this topic, from other topic also, feel free to contact me either on our DAMS club. Okay, or on this WhatsApp number. All right. All right. Okay. If you want, I can add one more topic right now. If I can take one more topic, if you want. All cranial nerves, then all cranial nerves, though it cannot, it is not possible to complete in one demo session because it will take a lot of time, isn't it? I will include in the next class that I can in, do that I will include, right? Yes, this is my WhatsApp number, beta, in case of any doubt. Or for the images, for the cadaveric images, we have the like one course is there. Okay, you can just check that also, and or else I will start putting the question in the club so that you can practice there. Okay, demo session we can take for any other topic also. Cadaveric images I can start putting there also in the club. That way we will be benefited in like both ways. We'll be studying, revising the theory, also that cadaveric images. I'll start putting in the club. Okay. Yeah, I will upload my class. Even my previous class is going to be uploaded. Okay. Someone is telling to take a lengthy topic, some is telling to take a small topic. So that is why it becomes a little difficult for the teachers to. All right, so I will take medium size topic, okay? Not too small, not too lengthy. All right. All right, take care everyone then. All the very best from my side. Okay, God bless you all. Thank you.